My name is Tim Marin, and I am the product manager for our continuous flexing line of cables here at igus called Chainflex. Today, we're going to talk about how to strip back a cable and prepare the ends for termination. So we're going to use hand tools today, although there are machines that can do it if you already know a predetermined length and you're looking to do multiple quantities. So the tools that we typically use in the industry are cable cutters to cut your bulk lengths of cable. We also have wire strippers that are used to terminate the insulation material on the conductors themselves. And usually this tool is broken out and it shows you the gauge size on both sides of the tool for whether you're looking for solid copper or stranded copper. Now today, we're going to strip back the cable using two different methods and two different tools. The first tool is going to be what's called a Jokari knife. It's common in the industry, and it's a useful tool for stripping back round cables, which is what igus offers. So with a Jokari knife, we have the blade at the very tip, we have the hook that goes around the outer jacket of the cable, and at the very bottom, we have the red dial. The red dial actually turns the blade at the top to push it up higher or down lower based on the depth of the jacket material. So basically the thickness around the conductors themselves, or on a shielded cable, the thickness of jacketing material around the outer braided shield. I'm also going to use what we typically use in the fields, which is a universal or a utility knife to strip this back as well. So first, let's use the Jokari knife. So with the Jokari knife, again, like I said, we have the blade. I've already predetermined the length with the red knob at the bottom. So I'm going to put this around the outer jacket of the cable by pushing this metal piece. And the metal piece is on a spring, so when you push it around the outer jacket, all you have to do is let your thumb go, and it immediately snaps and closes that gap. So next, the blade will go into the outer jacket material, and you can twist it radially a few times to make your cut. Then, once the circular cut is made in the outer jacket, you can then pull it horizontally, or the length of the cable, to make that cut so that you can peel back the jacket material. As you can see, the length cut we can peel back all the way down to our radial cut, at which point the jacket will come apart around the conductors. So you have your straight cut of outer jacket, and you have what we call leads, or flying leads, of your exposed conductor with the insulation still on. Now from this point, we would typically take our conductor or wire strippers, and we would usually choose the right gauge size, find the correct hole, and individually for each conductor that we need to terminate, strip back the insulation material. Now you may have noticed that there's also some of this white powder or talc coming out when I strip the jacket back. This powder allows for the conductors to have good abrasion resistance when moving against each other inside the cable carrier as the cable is moving. As you can see in the strip back piece of outer jacket material I also have here, there are almost grooves on the inside of the jacket material that I cut. This is because igus uses gusset filled pressure extruding, and that's when we push the jacket material in between the conductors to fill in all of the gaps. What that does is it keeps the conductors in place during continuous flexing. Now let's take a look at the second way to terminate a cable, just using a regular utility knife. For a standard utility knife, we're going to use the same type of cuts that we used with the Jokari knife, but if you don't have one of these handy, any standard universal or utility knife will still do. So first, you do the circular cut. Now how you do this is you put your thumb on the top of the cable, you put the blade underneath it, and you rotate the cable and the blade back and forth. Now it's important to be very careful as you do this, because you don't want to cut into any of the conductors, meaning you don't want to cut the insulation material and expose the bare copper at the point where we're currently cutting the outer jacket material. And so as you can see, I have one cut here. So now the next thing we want to do is make our length cuts. As we cut this cable lengthwise, it's important again to note the depth of the blade so as to not cut into the conductors themselves. Now, on the Jokari knife, we just made one length cut. That's because the blade has already been inserted into the outer jacket material, and so it's already at the correct depth, and then you can just make the same length cut without having to reapply the tool. When you use a utility knife, it's much easier if you actually make one length cut and then flip the cable and make the same length cut on the opposite side. Now, what this allows for is an easier peeling back of the outer jacket. So you almost peel it back just like a banana. You now have two cuts, so you have two different sides of the outer jacket material to peel back away from the conductors themselves. And as you peel back, again, we see the talc, but it'll also go down only as far as that first circular or radial cut. And again, now the conductors are ready to be individually stripped and prepared, whether they're hardwired or put into a connector. So now that we've gone through how to strip back a cable with hand tools, one of the other questions we get is, why are igus cables a little bit harder to strip than most of the other cables I've stripped? The reason for this is usually the jacket material and the inside materials of the cable itself. Igus chooses materials based on their use inside of a cable carrier application, good for millions of cycles, backed by our cable guarantee. Igus actually came up with a solution for this that we call the CF rip. Inside of our cables that are unshielded, we typically have a nylon ripcord inside the jacket material. What this allows for is an easier stripping ability once we've made our initial cuts. So for instance, on this piece, we've stripped back the conductors to a predetermined length. Now we know that there's a chance, because we used hand tools, that anything between where the jacket material is and where the ends of the conductor are, there is a chance that we nicked the insulation material on one of the conductors. So how do we prevent that moving forward? With the Chainflex rip, it not only helps strip cable 50% quicker, but we can also use something like a pair of needle nose pliers to twist up the nylon cord and pull back on the outer jacket. And what it does is it strips the outer jacket material from the predetermined cut length all the way to wherever your total strip back needs to be at. And we know if we use the rip cord that we haven't hit any of the conductors. What that means is from this distance to wherever we stop stripping the cable, we know for a fact that the conductors have not been compromised, because we are no longer using blades and industry tools, but rather a simple nylon cord. Now, we can use a screwdriver and just wrap the cord around and pull back on the jacket that way, or one of the more common tools that we use to strip back the CF rip cord is a pair of needle nose pliers. So you just grip it at the very end, you wrap it a few times, holding where the strip back length is. We can then pull on the rip cord. And as you can see, we've stripped the jacket back from here all the way to here, which is where the rip cord ended. And again, like we've done earlier, you can now peel back the jacketing material to see the conductors. And again, what this means is, having not used any kind of blade or other hand tool, we know from this point all the way up until this point, the conductors are 100% safe and untouched. If you want to learn more about how you can source a cable that has the igus rip cord or can guarantee you longer life inside of a cable carrier application, please visit us on the website or click the link below. Thanks for watching.